sexual exploitation is the first that is faced by the women in the cinema, and who are refusing to cooperate, they are sidelined basically from the industry. It is about the HEMA committee report. Although it has been in news since so many days, and HEMA committee was basically set up in 2017 as the case was filed by the Kerala woman who was working in the film industry, and how HEMA committee has exposed the lacunas or the problems faced by the women working in the film industry, and it has highlighted the exploitation faced by the woman. You can see there is another editorial which also says the reality of the real life exploitation as a structural problem. So this editorial wants to say, as it is a structural problem, we need to bring the structural reforms to tackle this problem. After this, we have basically, it has highlighted that sexual exploitation is the first that is faced by the women in the cinema, and who are refusing to cooperate, they are sidelined basically from the industry. And what kind of highlights is given by the basically this report, there is a problem of the casting couch, and in fact also they face the sexual exploitation and assault in the film industry. Another thing also faced by the women is they are not having the essential facilities. So two kind of exploitation faced by the women in the film industry. One is sexual exploitation, and the other thing is they do not have the essential facilities. For example, the toilets, changing rooms, safe transportation and accommodation. And it has also highlighted that discrimination in remuneration is also seen. So there is a discrimination in remuneration between the men and women. It means it is not basically fulfilling the goal of DPSP, Directive Principles of the Street Principles. Thereafter, there is a lack of binding contractual agreement. So there is a no binding contractual agreements. It means once they have also completed the movie, but after that they can be tortured or blamed or the blackmailed that your movie or the film will not be released, and nothing will change unless the state governments involved meaningfully. It has highlighted we need basically a meaningful involvement of the state government to deal with this problem. The major other concerns it has highlighted, there is a basically producers warned by the power group not to cast the actors which are basically fall out of the favor, and after even the release of the movies they are prevented as a film chamber of commerce has to issue the NOC. So for this they are blackmailed, and also we have discussed there is a lack of essential facilities, and junior artists even treated as a worse in the than the slaves, and they have to work for extending up to the 19 hours. In fact, maximum working hours have been mentioned by the labor laws, but as the labor laws actually being better implemented, we need a better implementation of them. And we have already told you there is a lack of written contract between them. And another alarming finding is many men assume that women willing to perform intimate scenes on screen are also willing to do offset. So basically it is highlighting that there is a stereotypes and the grow socialization of the industry due to which these women are facing such kind of exploitation. And after this, there are the social problems that has been highlighted by the editorial. It is saying this problem is existing in the film industry because of the society social wrong socialization. It means women are burdened by the stereotypes. They are facing some of the stereotypes. Stereotypes means basically judging or taking all of the category or based on one feature and expectations about how they should behave. They are some, in fact, we recently have seen the case of Kolkata case, and thereafter we have seen the case of the school going girls, and in this, all this is highlighting there is a need of changing some attitude among men, and ranging from what to wear, what friends to have, in individuals choices is too often stolen from women. And we have seen the already the case of the Kolkata, and the normalization of the objectification has been seen in this kind of. And we have seen the Vishakha guidelines were brought in 1997, which has highlighted we need to bring some reforms to bring the protection at the workplace for the women. But we took 16 years to bring the legislature actually as a sexual harassment of the women at workplace prevention, prohibition and redressal. It was brought in 2013. But although it was brought in 2013, but it has not been implemented actually in all the enterprises. It has highlighted that we need to basically build internal complaints committee. So internal complaints committee needs to be established under this act. But this HEMA committee has highlighted this kind of committee is actually not helping in the film industry. However, indicated that ICC is not suitable for the women in the film industry because these are basically ICC is being influenced by the abuser because they are a power holders. That is why this is not basically able to help the women. So we need a independent forum constituted by the government to deal with the problems faced by the women in cinema. After the Justice HEMA committee, maybe the question could be asked directly on the film industry, but I think it will not be the case. Rather, they will make up some question on the women's safety in the workplace. The broader question will be built. For that, they can ask what kind of basically safety measures or the steps taken by the government. You need to mention about the Justice HEMA committee, Vishakha guidelines about this act, internal complaints committee. These kind of the measures needs to be mentioned, and in this you need to prepare and know about the issues therein also, so that you will be able to write the way forward. Even if the broader question comes on the women empowerment, there also you can mention the recent context of the Justice HEMA committee, because it has highlighted the exploitation faced by the women, and it also tells there is a need of the reforms in every sector. As in the Kolkata, we have seen how a doctor professional was not safe at its workplace itself, and she was a professional. And there in the film industry we have seen, in fact, if you understand, the case was filed in 2017, but now also Justice HEMA committee report has come just now, and in fact the trial has not been completed. You need to understand the additional safeguards for the accountability can be introduced. But as in the Nipun Saxena versus Union of India, it has explained how the name of the survivor need not to be disclosed. But still, in India, women does not want to report such kind of incidents. Why it is so? Because there is a lack of empathy among the society. They basically demean those women, and that is why they don't want to explain or expose their name. Society which looks at the survivors of the sexual assault, misguided empathy is there. They feel disgust instead of supporting and trust her. And in fact, in some of the cases we have seen, even the family members do not support women to report such kind of incidents, because these are being basically taken as an insult for the woman. But the reward should be there, and it should not be insult for a woman, but rather it should be insult for the other man. And sexual assault cases takes years to complete. Even in the case of the Justice HEMA committee report, the Kerala film industry case, still the trial has not been completed. There is a basically issue of the judicial pendency. With this, you can see we need a basically structural reforms. For example, if the basically trial, fast trials can be done, then also the reporting can be increased. And the other thing is the societal or the attitudinal changes need to be done. There is a need of the better implementation of the law. For example, we have discussed about the sexual harassment were at Workplace Act 2013, and if the guidelines come, there is a need of the basically faster legislation by the government. And in fact, we can bring basically independent committees rather than just internal complaint committees, so that more accountability can be established. And there is a need of more independence. I hope you are able to understand what kind of points need to be mentioned in the exam hall.